Have a fabulous day, my dear students. This week we will be learning a poem from your honeycomb text, Garden Snake, written by Muriel L. Soni. She was born in California in US, and she has written a very simple poem which tells about snakes. Especially she is mentioning here about a garden snake which is harmless. Children, you know, normally majority of the snakes are harmless. Even then, people are afraid of the snakes because they don't know whether the snake is harmful or harmless. So, let's know about the poem. Garden Snake. Page number 137 of your honeycomb text. Have you ever seen a snake fighting a mongoose? Or getting into a hall? Or swimming in the river? Everyone, almost everyone believes that snakes are dangerous. Some are, most are not. Read this poem on a harmless garden snake. So, here in the text it is asking whether you might have seen a snake fighting with a mongoose. Normally, snakes are afraid of mongoose. Only mongoose can fight with the snakes. And people are afraid of the snakes even though majority of them are harmless. People think that snakes are dangerous. This is the reason why whenever they happen to see a snake, they will find a stick and try to kill it. So, let's see what is the poetess written here. I saw a snake and ran away. Some snakes are dangerous, they say. But mother says that kind is good. So, what happened to the poetess? When the poetess reached the garden, she saw a snake and she ran away. Why she ran away? She ran away because they say snakes are dangerous. What are they here, you know? They means the people. The people are telling snakes are dangerous. But mother says that kind is good. That kind is good means the snakes which are seeing in the garden could be good. And eat some insects for his food. So, when he begins in the grass, I'll stand aside and watch him pass. So, at first the poetess tried to run away from the snake. But whenever her mother told her that these snakes are harmless, she just saw. When he means the snake wiggles, it is the movement of the snake is known as wiggles. So when the snake wiggles in the grass, that means when the snake moves in the grass, I stand aside, I stand one corner of the garden and watched how the snake ran away. It wiggled away. So, the garden snakes are useful to the garden because they will eat up the insects for his food. And tell myself, there is no mistake. It's just a harmless garden snake. So, at first she tried to run away, but whenever her mother says it's a garden snake, it is harmless, it just has come to eat up the insects, then I just watched the garden snake a little aside and I let it go because it is a harmless snake. So, it's a very simple poem, children. You once again read the poem. I saw a snake and ran away. Some snakes are dangerous, they say. But mother says that kind is good and eats up insects for his food. So when he wiggles in the grass, I stand aside and watch him pass. and tell myself there is no mistake. It has just a harmless garden snake. So, whenever I could see a garden snake, and when his mother told her mother told her that the snake is harmless, she just allowed the snake to pass. And in her mind, she is telling it is no mistake to allow the snake to go away. And working with the palm, answer the following questions. Pick out the line that suggests that the child is afraid of snake. The answer is, I saw a snake and ran away. This line tells that the child is afraid of the snake. Which line shows a complete change of the child's attitude towards the snakes? Read it aloud. It's just a harmless garden snake. That's the answer for that question. Third question. But mother says that kind is good. What is mother referring to? Here the mother refers to a garden snake which the child had seen. Find the word that refers to the snake's movements in the grass. The answer is wiggles. A snake has no legs or feet, but it moves very fast. Can you guess how? Discuss in the group. This you can think and discuss. You might have studied about the movements of snakes in science, and you could understand that actually the movement of a snake is called slithering. The slithering of the snake is due to the scales present in its body, as well as the muscles present in its body help it to wiggle or slither on the ground. Can you recall the word used for a cobra's long sharp teeth? Where did you come across this word first? The cobra's long teeth are called fangs. Okay students, so read the poem very well and write the answers in your English notebook.